All right, so we'll be back from the commercial break. The break was because of rain. Now you to come here, oh? Okay, players, get ready. We're going to start. Now we stopped. Are we ready? Yes, check. All right. Okay. We are live at Bengwa Championship Live on Facebook, our YouTube channel. You can catch all the games live. And on our app, Deep End Sports Media application. Okay. In the blue corner. All right, in my blue corner. In my blue corner, I have Salim Lubega. Blue corner, I have Salim Lubega. Here comes Salim Lubega. The blue corner. I have Salim Lubega. Salim Lubega. Players, please try to be fast, please. Salim Lubega, please try to be fast. We are live at Bengwa Championship Live. We are live at Bengwa Championship Live. Here comes Salim Lubega. And in the red corner, I have Kagwa Timothy. Red corner, I have Kagwa Timothy. Sorry for interruption. I think there have been some changes in the fixture. Sorry for that. Sorry. Okay. All right, check. Here comes, sorry, we're back. I think there was a misunderstanding in the preparation tent or the players tent, but I think we are back with the same players. Here, we are back with Salim Lubega and I think we are back with Salim Lubega and Kagwa Timose, who is in the red corner. Our red corner of Kagwa Timothy. All right, yes. Kagwa Timose, please, where are you? The referee is waiting for you. Okay, here comes Kagwa Timose. May the best player win. Good luck.
come back as we get prepared for our next session. Opening up. Nice jump there. Starts off in style, starts off with speed. A very active group, 55 kilos. Both of them seem to be short enough for quick movement. The game has started after a weather break. Surface was a bit slippery. Nice route. Very active pair here. The referee is finding time to set them apart. Salim in the blue corner and Farouk in the red corner. Trying themselves, testing themselves. Nice movement, nice handwork. Farouk and Salim. Nice body shots there from Salim. They're all mining their guards, they're all mining their defense. No one wants to give chance to the other. Surface still a bit slippery, but they're finding their way. Nice right hook there from Salim. Very swift match we have from two very light opponents who are still finding their ways of studying each other. I don't think we're going to say knockout here. First round is off. They check up and then they go back to their corners. Rather a bit of a fast-paced match. Salim and Farouk. You can imagine the pressure they're having at this moment after opening up and finding out. We both have the same size, the same reach, and very agile in terms of speed and accuracy. But the heaviness of the punch is really more into the weight that you're seeing. These are people who are playing in the lower weight, featherweight. Live here on Bingo Fight Championship on Deepen Sports Media, wherever you're working from. Enjoy the games. We had a bit of a break there from action because of the body shot. Very relaxed, very composed. Farouk seems to be in control of this game. Nice hand jab there on the head. Nice work there, pushing his opponent to the more to the ring. Farouk seems to have gone in more of a defensive mode as Salim goes on the attack. Nice work there. I think he's waiting for the jabs in between the punches of Farouk. I think it's found out it's more of speed that's going to help him and not necessarily the power. Nice handwork there from the left jab from Farouk. The aggression of Farouk seems to be taking this game to a next level. Salim is very patient. Nice right jab there from Farouk. Goes for the head body shot. Farouk very composed. play these games from being a fight championship. And tonight, as we enjoy ourselves in this game, Kagolo Farouk and Salim Lubega. And the referee gives it a bit of a break. An exciting match we're having today, rather. We've had already 3 matches, 1 TKO in the very beginning. As Salim and Farouk pace it out. Nice handwork there. I told you, Farouk seems to have taken control of this game in terms of patience and power. He's having a better reach, slightly heavier than his colleague, but in terms of the throw of punches, it's more of a defensive versus an offensive game we're having here. Goes for the right hook, slams it on the body, but Salim seems to have contained it. And there goes the second round. Both go back to our sides and find a way of getting some instructions from our coaches and see how we can come back in this game. So far so good for Farouk. So far so composed for Salim. Hopefully the next round will determine what will happen in this game. Nice handwork there from Farouk. We're figuring it out slowly by slowly that this is a very energetic game for Salim. He's coming back in this round. He's trying to get to the weaknesses of Farouk. Very good footwork there from Farouk. His guards are down. Nice work there from Salim. His defense is superb. Nice hook there from Farouk. Straight to the head of Salim there. Game is getting better. We're trying to see how it's going. I told you this game may not in a knockout or something, because both opponents are really finding a lot of space. And they're using a lot of their speed. Nice work. Farouk seems to be tiring out. I think he's had a very long run. Hopefully he doesn't pay at the end of this game for being too fast. Nice work there from Farouk. I think he's trying to slow down as Salim contains him a bit. Nice hand jab there from Farouk, straight to the head of Salim, and that would count. Body shot there from Salim. Nice handwork there from Salim. Remember to go for this game a bit late. Nice nice work there. Straight to the head of Salim. As the referee breaks it down a bit. Go for a water break as the referee cautioned Salim and asks him whether he can push forward with this game. And he says he can move ahead. Win the last round of this game. And the referee signals the fight to go on. I think Salim is getting tired. Nice. Good handwork there. Misses. Very good defensive posture for Salim. But I think he has decided to be on the defensive for a very long period of this game. I don't know whether he's going to come on the offense and try to win this game. Because time is tickling out, and I think and there we go for the end of the third round.
The results in my hand. The guy in the red corner, Salim Luega, who is then in three rounds. While the blue corner in three rounds, he had 30. And I would like to announce officially the winner. And the winner is the blue corner, Kagolo Faluk. Thank you. Okay, players, get ready for the next game. 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 Players. And in the red corner, I have Semogerere Muhammad. Presenting the red corner. Semogerere Muhammad. Red corner, I have Semogerere Muhammad. Here comes Semogerere Muhammad. Yes. I can see the fan base. I can feel the fan base. Yes. I can see the fan base. The fan base is so high. Yes.
Next match here.
And in the blue corner, I have Blessing Eric.
The The introduction.
The blue corner, I am blessing Eric.
Eric blessing. And the blue corner makes his way to the ring.
Guy in the blue corner is blessing Eric.
Steps on the ring.
Yeah, here comes blessing Eric.
Blessing
bread.
Eric.
The man
is escorted
with the
by
bread.
A crowd from Kireka.
Please, fans.
Some space. Very, very big gathering
some space.
Here in support of the homeboy.
1 hour, Kalotila Vika. Blessing Eric.
Blessing
thank
Eric
you.
From Chireka.
Yeah.
In the Bingo Fight Championship. His first match. Of the
may
Bingo
the best
fight
fighter win. Thank you.
Everybody seems to be excited. As Mohammed takes on Blessing Eric in the fourth game of the evening. Everybody seems to be excited about this match because of the homeboy, Mohammed. We saw him play in the 31st crossover night where he fought a Kenyan opponent and surely downed him by the fourth round. And gave a very good performance of himself. Very exciting young player who has just joined professional boxing. Trained from Bingo Fight Championship Club. Putting on the red trunks, Mohammed, against Blessing Eric in the blue trunks. Shall we open this game? Blessing Eric seems to be taller, having a better reach. Mohammed, slightly short, but a bit of a thicker body than him. What Blessing Eric doesn't have in height, surely Kato has in a bit of size. As we open up this game. Opens. Mohammed, fan favorite, has a very big support ahead of him. Every punch he throws sends the crowd here. Nice handwork there from Kato. Mohammed. No excuses. The surface is very dry. And surely, the homeboy seems to be having an upper hand. Nice right jab here. Takes down Blessing. Takes him to the ring. And the referee sends him back to his corner. And the crowd are busy saying, hey, don't finish it so early. Still a long way to go. Very nice composure from Mohammed. Blessing Eric still studying his opponent. He knows there's a bit of danger. Mohammed is right. Contains him a bit. Good work from Blessing Eric. Seems to be cooling down the aggression of Mohammed. He's finding a way to stop him a bit. Nice work there from Mohammed. The crowd is cheering up. And the referee sends him to his corner and hopefully, gracefully, the round comes to an end and saves Blessing Eric a bit. A very exciting first round here. Kato, the fan favorite. Yeah? nice work there from Mohammed. Nice job there from Blessing Eric. I think one of the things that Blessing has to do is to avoid the rapid onslaught of Mohammed. And there you go. I think he's trying to learn the trick of Pepe holding him up, because as it goes, the power of Kato Mohammed seems to be overwhelming. Blessing Eric seems to be someone who is taking this game a bit slow in the beginning. And I doubt that's the idea that Mohammed has. Swings there. Nice work there from Mohammed. Goes, pushes him to the rim and throws him down. Surely the referee has a word or two for Blessing Eric. Asks him whether he can live up to this game. Tries to beat him the count. And signals the game to begin again. As the fans are starting to get excited. Nice way they are bringing up. Nice swing there, but I think every time he swings, he gets in a bit of trouble. Kato taking advantage of Blessing's slow pace and overwhelming him on every attack. He knows his job, he knows what to do, and surely he has a crowd behind him that he has to keep following him. Nice handwork there, Blessing Eric. Is going on well. Mohammed Nabajona Ati. We start the third round of this match. Mohammed Kato, Blessing Eric. I think he has had a couple of words from his coaching staff. There we go. Mohammed seems to be not stopping on aggression. He's coming full front. He has a very powerful left hand. Blessing Eric pushed, overwhelmed by the power. And that is it. It seems to be Mohammed is not letting go of the aggression, and Blessing Eric is finding it so hard to defend against a very aggressive man with a very good following here. All the fans are turned up to watch only Mohammed Kato today, a fan favorite, a star of Bingo Fight Championship, making himself known on the canvas. A few jabs there from Eric. Goes for the left jab. seems to be on a defensive mission. But time is running out for this match. He needs to go on the attack. He had moments when he's gone down on the canvas twice. And that surely counts. You can hear the instruction that the crowd are throwing on the canvas there. I think they want a KO. But that won't come easy. Man from Chireka came to win. And the man from Mukono seems to be on the mission there. Kato Mohamed, he wants to summarize this game. But the opponent is very experienced. He knows this is not going to go down the way he wanted, but he has to surely take this game barely to the last minute, at least on point decision, but not a KO. Goes for the headshot. Mohamed, this game is not going to be easy for him. And it comes to the last round of this match. It's been an exciting adventure. As we go to the final announcements of this game, the referees will do their job. The fans expect Mohamed, the red corner, Katof, a fan favorite from Mukono. He's grown through the ranks of Mukono training. And surely,
Wow. It was so an amazing fight. But I think I have a winner. Red corner, Mohamed. Mohamed is our winner of the day. Yeah, I can see the celebration from outside. Hard luck.
Celebration from Mohamed Kato, having conquered his opponent on point decision.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Allow me bring you another fight of the day. And ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Okay. And in the red corner, I have Wandaiti Maisha. In the red corner, I have Wandaiti Maisha, the little boy. The little boy, Wandaiti Maisha. Okay. Wandaiti Maisha. Here comes Wandaiti Maisha. Okay. Wandaiti Maisha. Come back. Okay. Wandaiti Maisha in the red corner. Wandaiti Maisha in the red corner. And in the blue corner, I have Muganya Jimmy. Muganya Jimmy. Oh, the boy is already. Okay. May the best player win. Thank you.
Start this match of youngsters, very agile youngsters. They've come to entertain. The nice handwork there from the red corner. Punches him. Nice work there from the youngsters. The red corner and the blue corner. Finding their way in the profession. You can see the speed, the agility, and their fans came along. This is just a match to kind of keep the crowd down and inspire the young ones to maybe in future join the profession. Nice work there from the red corner. Can imagine how many young under 12 children here being inspired by a match of youngsters willing to join the professional rank. An excited crowd. Nice throwback there. Goes for the head shot. The man from the red corner. The blue corner goes for the right jab. Body shot there from the blue corner. And the crowd is quite focused on this game. They know it's a bit of strange for that age group to come in the ring, but there you are. Courage inspires, and the will, if it's there, surely. It's a bit of a shorter duration of the round since the age is a bit low. But they are good, give a very good account of themselves there. about to resume the second round of this exciting under 14 game. Blue corner, red corner, the check. This is just purely crowd arouser. Bit of a blue light until we go to the next game there to inspire some of the very young here to see this game as a sport worth taking up. Very good crowd here today. Outskirts of Mukono Town in Uganda. Bingwa Fight Championship. We've had a couple of exciting games. Nice headshot there from the red corner. Takes him up. Why not? Most of the fighters today had the left hand as a dominant hand, kind of keeping the right hand for the jab or defensive purposes. Body check there from the red corner. Blue corner seems to be tiring. As people on the side, they enjoy themselves to a Saturday evening of exciting boxing matches brought to you live from Mukono, from Deep End Sports Media. Your leading sports production and broadcast coverage. You can call Deep End Sports Media in case of any need in terms of live streaming, sports production, anything that really needs a huge production work at any level. Outdoor, indoor, any sport really. Nice headwork there from the red corner. I told you he reserves his right hand for the jabs and the hooks. Kind of keeps the left hand active. Good combination there from the red corner. Nice footwork. I told you it's a very exciting game we're having today. exciting matches.
Amazing fight. Someone in the stands just told me these are not the usual kids. Is it? Yeah? And our winner of the day is Wanditi Maisha in the red corner. Thank you. Yeah. Going to have our first women fight now. And in the red corner, I have Impindi Zena. In the red corner, I have Impindi Zena. Red corner, I have Impindi Zena. Try asking those. Boxing is boxing. Boxing. Impindi Zena, please, where are you? In the red corner, I have Impindi Zena. We are live on our Facebook channel and our YouTube channel. Bingwa Championship Live. We are live on our YouTube and Facebook. Bingwa Championship Live. We are live at Bingwa Championship Live on Facebook and on our YouTube channel. Bingwa Championship Live. We are proudly sponsored by Deep End Sports Media. We are proudly sponsored by Deep End Sports Media.
Honorably wins this.
Ladies, 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 all my two players, the one in the red corner, we are still waiting for you. You're nowhere to be seen. Okay, here comes Impindi Zena in the red corner. Mpende Zena in the red corner. As the one in the blue corner, you get prepared.
Mpende Zena, the first ladies match.
Okay.
Makes her way to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are getting our first women boxing championship fight now.
Make her first fight match in the Bingo Fight Championship.
Red corner, Mpende Zena. Please.
Very young.
Come to the ring.
Years of age.
And in the blue corner,
professional boxing.
We have Nakiriji. Nakiriji Shena.
She's escorted by her.
Nakiriji Shena. Nachiji
Shona.
Shena. Sorry for pronouncing.
She's a fighter of Bingo Fight Championship who has won all her previous matches. She's on her way to becoming the undisputed champion of the Bingo Fight Championship. She wins.
Here comes Nakiriji Shena. In the blue corner.
Shana
thank
making
you.
Her way, steps in the ring.
May the best fighter win. Thank you.
Shana, known here as a very fierce puncher. She's had a couple of matches in the Bingo Fight Championship. Most of them wins. The most remarkable one being the one she fought on the New Year's Eve. Against a very, very capable opponent, I may say. And surely she came out strong. She returns today. As the crowd presses to watch the first female match of the evening. Shona against Mpende. Quick start there. Nice handwork there from Shona. come to the end of the first round. Shona and Tende giving a good account of themselves, though we have not yet seen explosive moments of this game, but we are yet to see the rest of the game. Nice work there from Tende. Shona is very powerful, gives her one right jab, and she goes halfway down. And the crowd are already loving it here. Bit of a scary moment from Tende. Shona very composed. She seems to be having an upper hand in the control of the game tempo. Better reach. Nice jab there from Shona. Right cheek of Ntende. She seems to be a fighter. She seems to be going on offense all the time. But taking a few jabs from Shona. And she surely seems to be tiring her down by constant movement on the floor of the canvas. Nice hold up there, Ntende. Seems to be throwing her weight on. Ntende starting to pick up pace there and the crowd loving it. Shona giving some matching count to zero, but she seems to beat it. Ntende is on the offense. She knows she's short. Shona there. Very good work there from. She has a technique of holding Shona's body. Shona is having a lot of difficulty dispatching of Ntende. A rematch that we think this time Ntende seems to be more prepared for. Nice work there from Shona. Nice job there from Shona. Ntende trying to find her way up the girdle, trying to destroy the guards of Shona and try to put this game to rest. Very interesting game. Both of them starting to tire up. Was shouting there, Shona KO, but it doesn't seem to be the exact picture Shona is having on the floor of the canvas. You can visibly see she's tired from the events of this game. She's had three previous wins in this tournament, but this one seems to be, but the last one was also quite hard for her. She faced a very battle-hardened opponent, just like Ntende, never stops to come forward, never stopped to beat up the pace. She seems to be energized and she seems to be coming right at the thick of it, giving Shona a very hard time, Ntende having a better of this game. And the referee just trying to maintain calm in this game, otherwise Shona seems to be tired by the events of this game. She won't be having her way in this game as she used to. And you can see the female factor in terms of tiring. By the end of this third round, surely it will be a very tough match for both of them. Nice work there from Ntende. And the bell saves the day. It's not been an easy fight for Shona. I don't know how the next round is going to be, but surely a knockout is seen coming from any of them. Ntende seems tired, Shona seems tired. And the last three bits of endurance seems to be going to be the one to dispatch this game to the favor of either. It's been a very well even matched game. Body language of Shona shows the tiring levels are now high. As we come to the last round, the decisive round of this game, Shona against Ntende. It's more of an endurance match. Ntende seems to be with her guards up, Shona seems to be her guards low. And she reins in a combination there, one on the head, but she ends up by hanging around the body of Ntende. She knows she's more a better place to come in a stingray mode against her. If she lets her get up to it. That's a nice head job there from Shona. Quick jab there on the head of Ntende. She has adopted the trip of hitting and holding, because she knows if she leaves it open, it will be a bit hard for her to finish up this game. Zena, a very powerful boxer. She has a long way in her career, but surely she's so powerful and so determined. You hope as this game goes. Nice hand job there from Shona. Shona seems to come have a better timing. She seems to be more precise. Ntende seems to be better going for the body shots. Kind of wants to tie Shona down, but she seems to be leaving her head exposed to a couple of barrages from Shona. Stepping back slowly. She knows she just has to wind the clock down, but her opponent is not in that idea. She knows she has to go on the offense. Barrage of punches there from Shona. Hook there. Goes for the front. But her opponent keeps coming. Ntende keeps coming. Zena Ntende. From Naguru Boxing Club. She does semi-professional fighting in the Uganda Champions Boxing League. And Bingo fight champion, Shona. Very experienced. She knows she's less powerful than the opponent, but she's keeping the pace down and just using her long reach of the hands to keep her very well controlled in the game. The levels of energy on both sides are melting down, and all of them are asking for the, well, I know they're asking for the bell to go. And Shona seems to be very experienced. She leaves her to come. And there we go. Wait for the judges to make a verdict of this game. Very evenly placed. Both of fighters were very strong, very pace. But the level of endurance, the endurance levels are choking them both down. As the coaches throw instructions, I think one of the best instructions is going to be keep your guards up, run down your opponent, and wait for that decisive moment to strike. Between the two, I think Zena seems to be, Ntende seems to be more better placed to win this game in terms of the endurance. The fifth round of this game strikes off. Shona, maintaining her calm, goes for the head jab, gets it right, steps back. It's just more of a time-killing game, as the levels of energy from both sides seem to be coming down. Ntende, who was quite active, seems to be also slowing down a bit. She comes with a very nice right hook, but finds a decisive reply from Shona. As they both agree that this game has to go to the strongest and not the swiftest. Nice handwork there from Shona. Nice return there from the young lady there. She's kind of measuring up. Nice way. They both have a good timing for each other. All of them are waiting for the opening. None of them is going for the risky job they were doing in the previous rounds. Each of them is very cautious, waiting for the slight opening and then going for the sting. You can see both of them are now more in the zero mode. Nice work there from Shona. Goes for the hook, takes her down. And they hold up and the referee has to separate them. As I told you, this is a moment of truth for the one with the best endurance. And they are both slowed down a bit. They're both cautious. I think they had some instructions from their ringsides that you don't need to be aggressive. Nice work there from him, the short lady. Nice hand jab there. She goes straight for the face and Shona takes us in. Cause comes back, gives her a bit of a return, but she seems to be more energized. A couple of stings there from Shona. As the crowd start to get excited by a ladies' game, full of energy, full of skill. And everyone seems to be enjoying this game, from the youngest to the oldest. A very chilly Saturday evening that threatened rain, but didn't stop the hearts of people here to come and watch the game. Amstrad, the end of this round, fifth round of exhilarating boxing match. All of them are excited to end it with a win, but surely I think this game will go until the last moment and probably end in points. Shanna, nice handwork there from Shanna. She knows how to time, she knows how to go for the sting, and she waits. When I open it, kind of relaxed, and jabs in and jabs out. Nice work there from Imelda. Wow, what a punch. The referee says, are you okay? Very good timing there. Shona seems to be knowing her strength and her weaknesses on this opponent. She has stepped down, she's conserving her energy, and she knows surely this game, either way it can go. Naguru Boxing Club against Bingwa Fight Championship. The crowds are loving it. The guys are enjoying it. Hard work for the referee as we come close to the end of this round. Both fighters seem to be arguably tired. It's experience against endurance. Nice work there from Shona. And we come to the end of the fifth round, the final round of this game. Go back to our corners. Hey.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back from that amazing fight which you have just heard from the two beautiful ladies. But allow me give you the winner is Zira in the red corner. Thank you.
Zira
thank
this
you.
Game from
I can
the
see the
corner.
Happiness from her.
Shanna goes for
thank
her first
you.
Defeat in the Bingwa Fight Championship. She seems happy. She seems celebrating. Surely she deserves the win. A very fiercely contested battle. She takes his home on points.
Another fight from some beautiful ladies with talent. In my red corner, I have Serani Mary. In the red corner, I have Serani Mary. In my red corner, Serani Mary. Red corner, Serani Mary. Serani Mary in the red corner. Here comes Serani Mary. And in the blue corner, I have Mpindi Aisha.
another Hajat. Mpende Aisha. Okay, referee trying to check on them. Referee is trying to check on them as the coaches prepare to bring out their best skills on the players while the players prepare for the best fights. Allow me, let the viewers and the bystanders enjoy the game. Thank you.
It's a running Mary. Bingwa Fight Championship. Next match of ladies here. As we prepare to see the last few games of this evening. The sun is getting a bit less hot. And the moment is still good. The matches are still okay. Exciting matches we are watching today on this game. The running Mary having a rough time dispatching his opponent. First few minutes of this game, I've seen aggression from both ladies. And the ladies from Naguru seem to be having a very good account of themselves. Mary has never had such a vicious opponent I've seen in all the matches she has had in the Bingwa Fight Championship. Mary being cautioned there as the tempo of the game flares up. So running Mary on the defensive. Very arousing cheers here from the crowd. It's Rani Mary. She needs to get a better technique to handle this dispatch opponent. Otherwise, she's quite so aggressive. Nice headshot there. Nice return there from Serrani. Nice headshot there from her opponent. Serrani Mary is meeting her match today. Nice work. Very evenly matched game. Short lady seems to be having a better powerful punch than Serrani Mary. And they're all quite aggressive. Enjoying herself in the ring. Nice hit there from Serrani Mary. Hope she doesn't get carried out by the crowd. Nice handwork from Mary. Guru is up against Mukono. Nice defensive work there from Mary. Nice handwork there from Mary. Instructions from the crowd. Come on, Mary, kind of slowing down. She knows how to use a hand jab to just kind of check and have a feel of her opponent. Nice work there, but a quick return there from Mary. And now a 5-round match. If you start it on the very high tempo, you may end up losing it at the end, but this game seems to be going the Naguru way. Nice work there. The referee stops the match as the bell goes. Second round. Third match goes off. Third round goes off. Both coaches throwing instructions at their players. Mary Serrani. It's a match of Mukona against Lugogo. Naguru. Quick start there from both. Nice barrage of punches there from the young lady. Mary turns back. Nice work there. She sets herself. She wants the knockout. And the referee. I wouldn't think there was a bit of anything necessitating a caution there, as she did her work. very intelligent game they're both having. Shona and Mary today. I've made their matches. And I know it won't be long till they train again. With a better approach in this game. Nice work there from Mary. She goes for the hook, but opened it equal to the task. Very good defensive work and very good offensive work from the lady from Naguru. Just 17 years of age. And our opponent is just 18 years of age. Very young talent. Very nice work there from we've been having a lot of these games today. Bringing boxing to the community. Very enjoying moments of this being a fight championship if you're watching it from Deepen Sports Media. Nice work there from Serani. She goes on the defense, but I think this game is a little bit too hard for her. And the bell goes. As we see what comes from the judge's corner. Surely it's been a very, very tough match. I wouldn't be surprised.
We'll be back from this amazing fight of the day from the two ladies. First, let me first read for you the results. The first round, the red corner had 6, in the blue corner had 10. Round 2, the red corner had 20. Red corner had 20, blue corner had 4. And in the last round, I think which totaled up all the results. Blue corner had... Nope. Okay, let me just give you the winner because they didn't give me the results of the last round. And the winner of the day is in the red corner, is our winner. Thank you.
Zarina takes this. Very controversial.
Okay. Sorry. That was our last fight from the ladies section. That was our last fight from the ladies section. That was our last fight from the ladies section. the red corner in the main section, I have Cyril Georgi Marvin. Red corner, main section, main fight, I have Cyril Georgi Marvin. Red corner, I have Cyril Georgi Marvin. As Rock, where are you? Rock.
Cyril Georgi Marvin will be taking on the next match.
Red corner, I have Cyril Georgi Marvin. Rock has something for his boxer or player.
Yo, Gamba, DJ. Yo, yamugamba atia yenze wapu kaba kecho kamba rulire nze kurukutama wapu nemba ngomu wendule ndiza wa ye mukono siri wechi wapu lekalo babo ngako mazenze mu.
A couple of upsets this evening. Shona down, Mary down, and the visitors seem to be having control of this, the events of this game today, as we wait for the red corner to come in. Crowd is very excited here today. The crowd is excited. As we kick off the first round of this exciting match. Everything is in place. If you're watching this game on Deep End Sports Media, from wherever you'll be, and there goes. Nice start there. Straight to the point. Straight to the point of the match. A very aggressive start to this match. It's a men's game. Wants to floor his opponent without. Nice work there. Resistance, strategy. A fierce start for the man in the blue corner. Kagwa Timothy against Serumaga Marvin. Kagwa is known for his aggression. Wants to kill off this game in the early sessions of this game. But his opponent is living up to the task. Such an exciting start to the game. Kagwa Timothy goes down to the canvas to the applause of the crowd. The referee tells him to relax a bit, calm down. Helps him to the count. Checks him again and says, hey, let's get back on this game. It's just the start of the game. As we wait for more exciting games of the evening, the crowd is getting bigger here. The Bingo Fight Championship. We are witnessing power, we are witnessing aggression, we are witnessing skill. Kagwa Timothy trains most of his time from the Deep End Sports Media sponsored Bingo Fight Championship gym in Mukono. A fan favorite, known around this town. So, quite an explanation for the large turnout here today. The children are here, the adults are here, the youth are here. It's a very exciting evening of boxing. Nice swear from Kagwa Timothy, throws in a jab. His opponent is standing up. Another knockdown, takedown to the ground. Referee says, will you make it? It's working out well for Kagwa Timothy. Nice jab there from Seruga Marvin. Kagwa, the gas is there. Both fighters know the urgency of this game. If it goes beyond the third round without amassing a couple of points, it will be very hard to get winning points the fifth round. So I think all of them are utilizing the technique of coming up straight in the first early parts of the round so that they can catch up a lot. They start all over again. I think they've slowed down a bit, Kagwa. He has realized his energy levels are going to be wasted. And yet his opponent has nowhere to go. And there goes the count for Kagwa. He spent most of his energy trying to attack with a fury. And now
Omar Calvin. Just a simple reminder as usual. We are live on our YouTube channel. Bingwa Championship Live. Bingwa Championship Live. Please, players, if you hear your name, please ensure or try to keep time, please. The man in the blue corner The referee has started the count. The man in the blue corner, Omar Calvin, the referee has started the count, please. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes the man in the blue corner, Omar Calvin.
Omar Calvin joins up the blue corner and Necklet goes in the red corner.
Gentlemen. Okay.
Everyone is worried Necklet will lift up his...
May the best fighter who win. Please enjoy the game, the bystanders, and those people who are live. See you in a few minutes from now after this game.
See Necklet up against Omar Calvin. Omar Calvin, Necklet. Necklet goes for his first boxing match in Bingo Fight Championship. He's been weighing up a lot in kickboxing, which he has won most of his matches. He lost the first match of kickboxing in the Bingo Fight Championship, but he has kept on fighting. Today he tries his luck in boxing. I can tell you everyone here is worried that Necklet will lift his leg. But shall all bet on that? It's warming up.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Hope. Hope is coming back. Hope is coming back. It was a nice right jab to the ground. Yes.
Yes, 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 yes. I can see the happiness from the bystanders and the people who are alive, I think. Everyone is okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has the results in his hands.
Yellow.
Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for ladies and gentlemen, thanks for supporting Bingwa Promotions. And we have been with two prayers. Red corner is called Angelek, and the blue corner is called Omar. And then the winner is blue corner by KO.
Omar Calvin is our winner of the day. We are going to get some entertainment as we wait for the main fight of the day. We are going to have some entertainment as we wait for the main fight of the day in a few minutes, please. Players of the main event, please prepare as we get some entertainment.
DJ, let's come light it up again for the goddamn day.
Seta Green, Greenfield Grounds, Taka Junge, to be brief. And they come back for the next round of this three-round encounter between Kwizera and Ibramo. Referee calls them back. Kwizera goes on the offense. Seems heavier, though shorter. Goes for the kill. And Ibra sticks to his defensive mode. Nice left jab there from Chris. Another calls for this decisive punch. I think Chris wants to knock out this game. But Ibra Moore seems to be tight on his defense. The referee cautions Chris on the push. Nice right jab there, left jab there from Ibra. Body shot there from Kwizera. Very solid defense there from Ibra. Referee cautions again Kwizera against hitting the underhand. Very good combination and exchange there between Kwizera and Ibra. Ibra seems to be waiting for the decisive moment. And the crowd again goes crazy as a blue corner. Ibra takes his offensive statute. Can feel the crowd pressure mounting on Ibra, but also a very short time of miscalculation there from Kwizera. Nice work there from Ibra as Kwizera replies back with heavy punches. Body shot there from Kwizera. And the referee is quick to start that game. Kwizera very powerful there. Seems to be taking his opponent to the ropes, and the referee says, we don't want a push in that. Kwizera goes for the head body shot. And the referee stops the second round of this game. Still quite a bit of a stalemate because Ibra came back in this round a bit stronger and a bit more cautious, matching the aggression of Kwizera with a few left jabs, a good defensive workout, and a good footstep there. Come to the last round of this match. I'll prepare for the last and final match of this evening against Jab Jab, a favorite player here. We start the last round of this match. Kwizera against Ibramo. Gets a few instructions there from his coach. Nice jab there from Kwizera. He wants to break down his opponent. Nice work there from Kwizera. Seemed to be gaining the aggressive approach here in this last round, Kwizera. Not allowing Ibra any chance of attacking. Goes for the body shot. Kind of hold up a bit. And the referee says, break it up, break it up. Nice work there from Ibra. Very powerful player Kwizera is. He boasts of coming from the western side of the country. Kabale calls himself the Mchiga. His idol is Moses Gola. That's why sometimes he speaks a bit much before any game. He goes for the right hook there. Ibra seems to be... and Kwizera stumbles. But that was an intentional stumble because he was going for the offense. It doesn't count. Goes for the right hook. Nice work there from Ibra. An entertaining match there from both of the players, giving a good account of themselves. Kwizera goes for the hit and hold. And you can see the sense of tiring and desperation from Kwizera as we come to the end of the third round. A very interesting matchup here Kwizera is having. He seems to be tired. However, Ibra Mo seems to be just bringing on. The referee cautions Kwizera against pushing. It's so powerful, but however, sometimes... and the crowd is cheering on the blue corner. And the time at the ring is becoming a bit so hard for Kwizera to handle this match. He seems tired. And the referee asks him whether... We come to the end of the third round and the final round of this match. As we go to the judges for the final judgment on this game. It's been a very interesting game. And a fun game to watch. As always, Kwizera is very interesting to watch. But today seemed a bit difficult for him. Let's wait for the judges to
the red corner, representing the red corner, is Jab Jab. We are having the last game of the day. We are having the last game of the day. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen. In the red corner is Jab Jab. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, the red corner is Jab Jab. Jab Jab, players, players, please, players, try. Try your best. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes Jab Jab. With all the support from the people, from his crew, from the gang, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the boy from Gaza. Jab Jab, Jab Jab. DJ, Team Jab Jab or Team Alex Champ? Yeah? Judges. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming through. Judges.
Jab get some attention there, first aid. Keep him up. Hopefully it will be swift enough.
Ladies and gentlemen.
First loss in the Bingwa Fight Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, Jab got an injury while the game was still on. But I have the final results in my hands. The referee stopped the game and gave me the final results. And the winner of the day, I have the winner of the day, and is Alex Champ.
And Alex Champ wins the
Thank
day
you.
By way of technical knockout.
See you when you see me. Have
Thank
a good
so
night.
Thank you so much.
From Bingwa Championship Live and Deep End Sports Media. Yes. See you when you see me. Good night. Fire, cutting balls that is